Hey YouTube, what's going on? Mark here. Good morning, happy Saturday, and of course, happy Kenny Wallace 23rd birthday to one of my ultimate favorite actresses, Carrie Metters. But this is not what this video is all about this year, as you know, as it was in past years. So today is going to be a very, you know, action-packed day. So right now we're about to go get our haircut with cousin Kenny, an early morning haircut, unfortunately, because my dad sometimes, you know, and doesn't really think much about how we feel. But hey, what can you do? But anyway, I made sure to get my ass to bed really, really early last night, so I wouldn't be as tired as I would if I went to bed super late, like I have done many times in the past. But anyway, we're about to get a haircut and then come home. Off camera, we'll just most likely put the dishes away and then hopefully take a little bit of a nap, but not actually, we don't oversleep past 5:30, because at 5:30 we're going to Fireball Man's for our annual 2023 edition of our winter dinners with them. So therefore it's gonna be an action-packed day. This will be uploaded at the end of the night, and then tomorrow we'll be catching up on the Casey Atwood installment of The Really Loud House and the Johnny Benson installment of Welcome to Flat. So anyway, we're gonna do it a little differently. I'm not gonna give you the teeth brushing sequence because I just don't want to keep giving you guys the same wages over and over. I will meet you all at the barbershop where we're gonna go straight where we're going, which is exactly where we're gonna go to straight from here. All right, we've made it to Cousin Kenny's barbershop, and he has a video that he sent to me. I'm gonna try to help him upload to whatever channel he wants to upload it to. So anyway, let's get in the chair and get this fiesta going.
Lined up. and then excitement, like, yeah, I did it. It was more like, oh, thank God. If I miss that kick, we're cleaning out our lockers the next day. So stress, pressure, and conditions, I would say that's probably the one that I'm most proud of and probably the most difficult kick ever. If Adam doesn't make that incredible kick, there's a lot of things that would be different.
You know, when I think about Bill Terry and the kick that he made in that snow, we'll give him credit. But the game had long been over.
And I'm gonna walk to midfield, whatever the hell that is, and flip the coin to see who gets the ball first in overtime.
The coin toss was, it was super important because back then it was sudden death.
I changed on the blade, it went dark. Yeah. Hey, do you think they're going to change any of the rules since that, or change some of the equipment? Gear that the guys are
getting? They can't have equipment on the field now.
No. Well, no, like they're like chest guards or anything, or because of what happened to that dude, DeMar?
No, I haven't heard anything. Yeah, the Buffalo player. You were watching that game, bro.
Do you think anything's going to change?
I don't know that they're going to do anything.
Get them some different gear or something?
Yeah, the NFL Players Association has a...
It's almost inevitable because...
It was a freak accident. Shit happens.
Yeah, they have an agreement against the NFL. Because they told them, warm up for 5 minutes, we're going to get this game. We're going to play this game. And the players, it was weird. The players on both sides says, no, we're not playing this game. And they walked off. And the NFL wanted them to play. That shit came out later.
Okay, because of what happened, they didn't want to play because of what happened.
They didn't want to play. That's it. They don't want to play the game. They don't want to be on the field.
Almost like they went on strike.
Yeah. Yeah, they all got off. They all took showers, got dressed.
And just said, fuck it, we're going home.
Yeah. Mm.
So they later on released that? They didn't really do that?
Yeah, they haven't played the game. They canceled the game. So it messed up a lot of fantasy leagues. Like right now, I'm beating the other guy by...
They canceled the game all together, period.
Yep. They're not going to resume it at all, they said. I've been. It's all over social media.
How is that? Damn, that's crazy. So it fucks everything up.
So I'm going to beat the other guy.
So it's not fair.
It's not, but that's what they did.
Damn. Yeah. Man, so, go ahead.
My wife, she's in there for the championship. I'm in there for third place.
Because of what happened.
Yeah. Yeah,
there's a lot of people pissed off.
Oh, man,
millions,
I bet.
Millions and millions of dollars in fantasy football. You know,
flushed down the toilet.
That's the biggest bet around the nation, around the world, basically, is NFL football.
Yeah, that shit fucked up a lot. That shit fucked up a lot of money.
A lot of money, bro.
Based on what I was reading before the freak accident happened, it looked like it was going to be a great game until that shit happened.
Yeah, what about Skip Bayless, man? I heard he got some shit for what he said. Because he wanted the game to continue.
Yeah, they gave him some crap.
And rightfully so. I mean, I'm not even the biggest football fan, but even in basketball, Skip has a tendency to say stupid shit.
Skip Bayless?
Yeah. He used to be a good guy.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
He got a lot of shit for that.
Because I remember when I was younger, he always used to be on the San Antonio Spurs side. That was only because we were still winning.
Oh, two, you win it. Are you a Raider for life, or is you
for the
I know they're nuts. Why outside of February 13th, I've been taking a break from the game so I can provide better content and just be happy in the winter months too, and just not be a only quote unquote do it in the summer on the summer months only person.
I couldn't believe that.
Caliente. So hot that even my right foot went up.
You all right?
Mm-hmm. All right. Actually, then it starts feeling nicer, like the more it stays on. Going for a Bobby Labonte 360.
You said it right.
It's a suicide out there, but I don't think it's going to accumulate that much like it did like a couple weeks ago.
Maybe I'll have Mark shave my head one day.
That's an April Fool's joke, but I got to be careful I don't get reckless with it.
Yeah. Give Mark the clippers.
Yeah. The proper clippers so I don't cut you. I've been thinking about doing April Fool's videos for April Fool's Day each and every year. I just haven't thought of anything. Whether it be here or somewhere else.
I think we're gonna do one here one day.
Yeah. I've been thinking about doing one in the neighborhood as long as the weather's decent on April Fool's Day.
I got an idea, so yeah. We'll see if we can make it happen.
Yeah. What was that?
Probably do a month before April Fool's or whatever, I think it's have it saved.
Yeah. But when it comes to me, my friends doing it in the neighborhood, we can just do it actually on April Fool's Day and upload it at the also on April Fool's Day. Because in the neighborhood, you can just do it one and done. Here, like a public place like here, that takes a lot of work.
Put that nice smooth stuff on there.
Yeah, Carlos Santana and Rob Thomas. Okay, here we go.
I got this stuff.
I bet.
You say clean your neck and you're good to go.
Last one, buddy. Push it.
Yeah, did I tell you last time I cut you, did I tell you that my girl's pregnant again?
You had what?
My girl's pregnant again? I said,
oh, yeah.
You never told me that. Congratulations. Yeah. What's it going to be this time, a boy or a girl?
I don't even know yet. This is going to be in August.
Damn, it's going to, right as we're going to end summer, I think. What part of August? Early, mid, or late?
I'm not sure.
Wow.
She's
good. I haven't seen her since the day we met in 2016.
You got to go visit her one day.
No, because remember my mom took me that one time. That was the only time I saw Jen.
If anything, you can go visit her at her place, her salon.
Yeah, I wish she had a YouTube channel.
No, she don't got YouTube, but
I know Instagram. She doesn't. I just wish she did.
She got Instagram.
Yeah, I think I follow her there.
Give her some publicity.
Yeah, but if she had YouTube, she'd be just as good at it as you and me.
She loves a company, so I don't know. Stop by, say hi one day.
Yeah, I haven't been since December 2016, to be exact. I think my mom took me the same day I had a Christmas party at Murray Ridge pre-COVID. Oh my goodness, that looks great.
This is the front, and then this is the back. Which one do you like better?
Either one is fine with me.
Okay, that's
fine. All right, and that does it with the haircut with Cousin Kenny. We're all set like Jimmy Johnson. We go home, shave,
But I'm going to the Super Bowl, so I would like to the week before. The Super Bowl is...
You booking now?
Yeah, if you have time. Yeah. So we leave February 8th for Vegas. So it's a Thursday, so I like to get a haircut the week before if you're available.
So what, February?
Yeah.
What day?
So we leave the 8th, so the Saturday before that, the 4th.
Not me, because I already have a commitment.
Bro, I'm not gonna keep on bringing you back.
No, because my mom's taking me to a basketball game today. I'm serious.
Like 10 a.m. Saturday.
We can always do it the 11th or something.
I'm out of town. I don't come back home till the 14th.
Yeah, but I mean, it's not going to kill you to have me wait.
Sooner, though. Want to come in sooner? Or you want to come in Saturday?
Yeah, I want to come in that
4th?
Yeah, the 4th.
I got 10 a.m.
Okay, put me in for the
4th.
I'm
going to get you Monday. 4 o'clock.
4 o'clock.
10 a.m.
Yeah. And then for Mark, let me see. I'll bring them the next week then. Anyway, you always text me, or your app does.
You
want to
take this with me? You want your wine? I'll take them both.
You got a message for that one. What else?
Okay, don't say.
I know we do.
For Mark, let me see. So Mark, you said the 11th?
Yeah, the way before my, just in time for my birthday and the Spurs game, yeah.
Your mother's going to have to bring you. I'm out of town.
That's good. That's perfectly fine with me.
As long as you're here on time.
Yeah, you know how women are, bro.
Yeah, it's just sort of half an hour early or something.
Yeah, I always come early.
Okay, so we all got it taken care of. The next haircut video will be February 11th, and then the next thing will be a birthday party video at the Leah, the Rutherford, the Queen of Mossy Moss's Greg Biffle Sweet 16 poker game night. I think the season 2 premiere is today.
He's leaving now.
I think not next Saturday, but the Saturday after that. Yeah, that's that. Yeah. Therefore now we're all set like Jimmy Johnson. We're gonna go home, do a shave on my face. I mean, make sure we're double times the clean for the winter dinner with the Sorgs tonight. And then whether it be on or off camera, we're gonna put the dishes away. So I will meet you all at home when we all get settled in and, you know, continue, you know, preparing for tonight.
Coteando toda mi piel, tus andares provocando mi castidad, tus besos mitad mentira y mitad verdad, saben a manzana del paraíso de Adán.
Sola, sola,
me gusta pasear.
Fine form, so pick again.
La vida es pura pasión. Hay que llenar tu copa de amor. Para vivir hay que luchar. Mi corazón para ganar. Feeling in your soul is gonna take control. Nothing can hold you back if you really want it. I see it in your eyes. You want the cup of life. Now that the day's here,
It's still a tie. It's here, it's now. Turn up the lights. La compañía.
Look at that, clean as a whistle all the way around. So now, outside of, you know, putting the clean dishes away, all we have to do is wait for tonight and we'll be all set like Jimmy Johnson to spice up this video. So catch you all later on this evening.
Later that night.
All right, welcome back. We're on our way to Fireball Lands. I got my A1, you know, and of course I got my own Coke in case Fireball Man doesn't have it. So this is the second year in a row. And this year's the perfect day because doing it on Carrie Metters' birthday. So if you want to look at last year's vid version, which I think was the Winter Wonderland season 1 premiere, go check that out. Link in the description. We made it to Fireball Lands, and look at that! Look at that thing! This 48 is junk. We're in for a wild ass night tonight. That's exactly what they're doing on the damn TV. Why are we throwing them? Why are we throwing each other down like it's the WWE? Let's not do that tonight, please. This clip tells you it's just going to be one of those nights. It's going to be a long-ass one. It's the Fireball Man and his unnicknamed wife who just got back from Florida celebrating the Johnny Benson 10th anniversary. All right.
That's right.
Yeah, and we're trying to make sure we don't burn this shit because apparently, according to Fireball Man, those fries aren't crispy enough.
They're not crispy enough. I know darn well you ain't going to go with them.
Right. I also brought my own Coke in case you didn't have Coca-Cola.
Oh, that we did.
That's
the thing
we did for that. That's why I brought my... I was going to drink that second one at home, but I ended up taking a nap before I got here because I knew I was going to need it.
Have you thought about trying to get a sponsorship with Coke?
No, but I have... With my TV brought...
Every TikTok, every video, yeah. Everything.
How do you know that if you don't have TikTok, Fireball Man?
I don't have TikTok, but I know darn well. I know you, Mark.
Yeah. Not to mention that in my TV broadcast style YouTube videos of basketball games, I might make up my own sponsors.
You need to get yourself a sponsor.
Yeah, I know my friends in Ridgeville High pretend it's ESPN, but for me, I do Fox Sports because I grew up with it as a NASCAR fan. Here come the rambunctious kids. Where are they coming from? No, it's coming from over here. Yep, there's the queen of tearing shit up.
Hey, who's that? Is that Brandon?
No, that's me. Brandon's not here, man. He has a new job, remember? Oh, shit. All right, they're testing the VR system. Abby Sorg and Gavin McGraw. Oh, yeah, and Abby got a new YouTube channel, so subscribe to her. Link in the description. I think at night's end, after we're done tearing the shit up, we'll give her a shout-out video in a separate video outside of the one we're recording right now. Okay, that was some dead silence there for, like, a couple seconds. I have no idea.
Okay. Thank you for confirming that. Thank you.
Yes, I have watched videos.
They put it on.
I can't hear myself.
Gavin.
I can't hear myself on here.
Or they cook it or after
you
cook
it.
Is this Among Us?
Yes, this is Among Us.
Let me see. So you would give me back it.
I'm not done.
So we have to wait for all the players to get in here. Tell me
what, VR players?
Tell me guys when you're going to start because I'm not going to be playing this. Someone else is.
Don't look at me because I don't do this kind of stuff. Hi.
Cardiana. I was home with my kid, Mamiana. Real bitch, I don't be with all that drama. Nah. Money, my business, I'm a bother.
All right, here's my meal, everybody. Time to dig in like Dick Trickle.
So I'm going to do this like I used to when I was little. A1, I know, ketchup on the fry side steak.
I'm having a little bit of a stroke here. Catch up on the fly side, A1 on the steak side. This is like what I used to when I was his age.
Yeah.
Oh, was that the one I brought? Oh, it's okay. You can use it. I was just making it. That's why I was like afraid of getting them mixed up.
Why do you want steak sauce?
Yeah, but I gotta be careful. The steak doesn't touch it, and that's nasty.
That's the same steak.
Everybody
else
has. I hate when food.
Ketchup.
Wait, is my recording stuff in the way, Steve?
No, you're fine.
Okay. Get out of here!
Riley.
No, that's not Riley. That's one of the little dogs.
Oh, is it like the one with the curly hair?
I don't know if it's Harper or the other one. I can't remember the other one. It's Harper. I can't remember all the dogs, the little dogs' names. I haven't been here since with Sandy Ridge finale. Oh my God! I'm having a stroke tonight.
Yeah, you are.
Last time I was at work, which is yesterday, I was having a stroke in between sentences.
You wouldn't be able to talk.
No, because it's a figure of speech. Like, I couldn't figure out what I wanted to say. Like, I was mixing up my vocabulary. YouTubers I watch say that as a figure of speech when they don't know what to say, so they kind of mix up two words they want to use at the same time.
What?
Yeah, but you're right, too. Oh, but I didn't mean the deadly kind of stroke. I meant the speech kind of stroke.
Emma, have a fruit punch.
This is the best song ever.
Whose is that?
That's
Jaden's. Alright. I almost gave it to Emma. I'm glad I asked beforehand.
Do you want water or do you want a fruit punch or lemonade?
Me?
Emma.
Lemonade.
Lemonade.
Fruit punch. You want fruit punch?
What,
can I get you something
to drink? Lemonade.
Fruit punch. Well, Riley's tail just hit me.
Yeah.
No. Short
chocolate lemonade, half fruit punch.
Yeah. I
could
feel them under the table.
It had too much steak sauce on it.
Why didn't somebody hear? Like
steak sauce. Good. That's the whole point about steak sauce, Jaden.
Why just pour this on the steak?
Right next to it.
Be very careful.
No, it's just Debbie. I thought Bombastic Boy and his wife were here.
Wife?
I'm kidding.
Yeah.
La Vida Labrat is what started that for me and Bray.
Yeah, that's why I said be careful.
Yeah, Living La Vida Labrat is what started that for me before I met any of y'all. Back when I was obsessed with that show.
Riley, go away.
There's
yours.
Is this yours?
I don't care anymore. I can always get another one.
I'm not doing both. Which one?
Yes. Fruit punch.
I would have taken either or.
Do you want one of them?
No. I'm just saying if I was in Emma's shoes, I would have taken either. Get out of here!
Mama, I'm all done.
Oh my God, you tore that shit up like Terry Labonte.
I'm done.
I don't know who these people are.
NASCAR driver, number 5 Kellogg Chevrolet Monte Carlo for Hendrick Motorsports. This is before your time. Before Larson was the 5, it was Texas Terry.
Okay.
When Texas Terry began his semi-retirement, it was Kyle Busch before he went to Joe Gibbs to replace Bobby Labonte, his Terry's brother.
But I'm done. I get a burn.
Well, the bench is moving again.
Just like that, we're all done. We tore that shit up like Texas Terry Labonte.
Okay, so now we're chilling on the couch, letting the food digest, and, brought to soon, you know, to wash all this shit down. We got, it's not cold anymore because I fell asleep in my bedroom before I had a chance to open after reading the first one. Some Coca-Cola to wash it down. I have two more extra ice cold ones in the fridge and the Lenore fridge in my garage at my own house. So therefore, I'm going to be eating and drinking good tonight because we also cook steaks of our own at my house as well. So I don't even need it. I have unlimited data, so I'm good.
Yeah, but I need it to turn on the
light. Oh, okay. What were you gonna put on there? Oh, you already put it on.
I'm gonna do Fortnite.
Oh, this would make some good YouTube content on your new channel if you recorded that. I would watch that, even though I don't play it myself.
Probably gonna be shorts though.
Whatever makes you happy. I'm not gonna force you to upload long videos like I usually do.
I'm
like posting. No, he's gonna play Fortnite. I mean, you can always join us. Where I'm just sitting here. Crap.
You said I could play. Mm-mm. I never said you could.
I didn't even hear her say that, honest to God.
I'm your guest.
Oh, you have a PS4. See, if you're lucky, if you guys are lucky, and I hook up my PS4, I'm doing a San Antonio Spurs fanfic from with NBA Live 19. Jeez, I can't even finish telling you guys a story because you guys are hyper.
No.
Oh, Debbie's phone. Debbie told me she had her phone. Emma had your Dom's phone.
Yeah, but it's labeled my phone.
Which is so confusing.
I know.
Yeah. It feels good to see you again after the Sandy Ridge finale, which is also, you can check that out. Link is in the description, man. I mean, I just wanted, I'm like I said, I'm slowly growing out of the phase of, you know, just being just a quote-unquote do-it-in-the-summer-months person. So, therefore, I'm trying to expand my horizons and, you know, get out of the house in the winter months, too, which is why I'm going to a lot of basketball games this season. That felt good. You guys missed the five-minute laugh attack I just had. Afraid reasons I can't say on the interwebs. The first, we had the duo Reckless Abandonment trio. Now we got the Reckless Abandonment duo.
Where's the ball?
It went behind the couch. It went behind the couch. I swear to God. Oh, yeah, right. Exactly. Just like the one idiot neighbor I used to have in 2015 and 16, and even 17 said his motorcycle had a force field, which I actually believed. Whenever he would invite me into his house, because he's not here no more, because I can't talk about it on the internet, but he's not here anymore because there's some little personal stuff behind closed doors. But when he was here, whenever he invited me into the house, I'd walk around the other side of the car because of the fact that, you know, he used to tell me his motorcycle had a force field, so I'd walk around the other side like a force field was there. Oh, he found the ball, but then he lost it again. He lost it again. Yeah, I saw what you did. I didn't want to say anything on camera. It's failing with her, but you didn't even phase me. Oh, I got it. Who wants it?
Me.
Yes. I'm right here.
Oh, it is a super nice tie.
And
we do spend a decent dollar. I'm not gonna lie.
Ready?
Yeah.
Who's gonna throw?
Oh, I made it teleport into my bedroom.
Oh yeah, right. Why are we throwing shit? Oh my goodness.
Okay. Yeah, like, take a photo.
We're doing it nicely.
Just that alone.
We're doing it nicely.
Caught and calmly. Nicely and calmly is what I wish you should do it as. And nicely.
No.
That's not nice and easy.
Hey. You didn't pass the door.
Hey!
Oh my God. Scott!
All right, the adults are chatting it up at the table while the kids are screwing around playing games on the floor. And the ball must have went all the way over there.
Did you get it?
No. Where the hell is it?
Oh,
you're making the dogs go crazy. Oh, God, no. No! Hang on a minute. Just like Malachi Barton on the Villains of Valley View. Or flash form.
I'm not playing, stupid.
And your dogs are somebody must be here. Now we're doing the quad. If duo is two and trio is three, then what's four?
Squad.
Well, it's the Reckless Abandonment squad, with now that Jaden's gone, it's me and Emma that's joined the Reckless Party. I hadn't wanted no part of it, but they kind of sucked me into it.
I'm staring right into your soul.
Yeah, I'll give him a dead stare. Kind of like what Boban did in his only year with the Spurs in 2016, which also was Tim Duncan's last year. Oh, yeah, against the Dallas Mavericks, yeah. Let's see if we can find a clip on that and we can throw it in there. Yeah, OG Spurs fans back when during the later part of our glory days of winning and winning every year, remember that. So yeah, that's exactly what Gavin was doing in the last scene. So therefore, right now Tim talking in the background. Right now he and Queen of Tearing Shit Up are playing. What are you guys doing? Or what are you guys playing? They're playing tennis basketball off camera. And they're doing it with their phones, which is why they're not recording this, because they're using the device they normally use to record it as a little stick figures, whatever the hell you want to call it. What the hell's that? Oh, it's a recorder. It's Queen of Tear, other Queen of Tearing Shit Up's recorder. You can't fucking hit. You can't fucking hit. Oh, now you can. Now you can as I say that. Okay, I need to get better with the zoom in and zoom out bullshit.
Throw it.
What the damn?
Oh, give me the ball and Snowman gets it.
What the damn?
Give me the ball.
In the wall, boom.
Give me the ball and Snowman gets it.
Well, this is some fucking destructive nature right here. Into the Fireball Man's basement, and this is for episode 2 of How Not to Play Pool 101. Oh my! That's what you get for playing a stupid game. How Not to Play Pool 101.
Hey,
Pop G,
bitch.
I am. I'm surprised I have not. I'm surprised I've never turned this into a series, How Not to Play Pool 101. Because you remember Josh's Bill Elliott 9 birthday party? Go look at that. Link is in the description. We had an episode like this of How Not to Play Pool 101.
Hi.
Hi.
My strike isn't here.
They're just doing it until all the balls run out. Two more to go. Oh, you missed completely. Let me look out. It's more. Is this air hockey or air pool?
Air pool.
That's what I figured.
Can you shoot the ball? Thank you.
Almost hit his finger. Yeah, oh, you did it.
Yeah, oh, gee,
so I know the old saying is a first time for everything. Well, this is the first time I've been in Fireball Man's basement. And look at Gavin and the queen of tearing shit up, having a go at it and how not to play pool 101. There's the other queen of tearing shit up. How Not to Play Pool 101 Episode 2 by Gavin and the Queen and a tearing shit up. As long as no fingers get smashed, we're gonna be quite cool. No fingers got smashed, but they knocked something down. Whatever the hell that was.
Can you get my balls?
Oh, the balls must have flew off the goddamn table. Get Vasaka never. Go, Gavin. I don't even give a shit who wins, honest to God. Damn. Yikes. Yo, how do you keep missing the hole, Gav?
I don't know. Maybe you
can. I'm Gavia. 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 Gavia.
Okay, that's getting annoying.
Talk about beating a dead horse. Junior.
Mine's
organized
by color. 8, 2, 4, 6, 8.
Look, mine's organized by color.
Mark.
Yes.
2, 4.
I see.
8. Okay, ready?
3, 2, 1.
Here we go.
Alan, you gotta move your fingers.
You're gonna get them smashed. Oh, you're flying off the table. That's why you don't do it hard. You're gonna get them smashed. We're just trying to keep you safe. Oh, one went in. I swear in the videos all the time, who cares?
Sorry, I can't help it. Oh, God.
Mine just went in. One of mine.
Oh, sorry.
Oh! Tina!
Two more to go. Oh, you won.
No, wait, we both won. No,
Abby got in first. He barely beat you out because yours went in a millimeter second after hers did. What the hell's that? Last round.
Now that I can dance now. Flip.
We've had 6 rounds so far. The last one depends.
So this, stop it.
The tiebreaker, okay? This round is the tiebreaker. Make sure we have me.
Seven, 5, 6,
2, 4, 6, 8,
7, 8, okay. 3, 2, 1, go.
A sudden death bitch.
I ain't losing this round. This round is a tiebreaker.
The psyche sudden death. Oh, Gavin's on fire. Careful! It just keeps going around and around and not in the hole. Oh, well, that green one's close to going in. Oh, there it goes. Who gets points for that green one? Who's gonna get points for that burgundy one? I hear someone. Oh, it's Queen of tearing shit up.
Okay,
This is the tiebreaker. Let's see. Well, it depends on what other older Queen of Tearing Strips is.
Abby.
Emma, no.
This
there you go.
You know, this one's mine, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm holding the eight ball so that when you're done shooting one of them in, at least. Hopefully.
Wait, someone else is here too? Oh, that one was robbery. Robbery.
No, what the?
Come on, you can't just abandon ship now. Man, so, but nobody has scored the last goddamn point.
No!
Abby!
Yeah?
Where's my phone?
Over here.
Oh.
Time out.
I win.
That doesn't count.
Yes, it does.
Bullshit.
Can I play now? No.
Almost. Whoever scores the win, Emma's got to play next. Oh, somebody won.
No.
Oh,
me.
Yes, I did. This is my eight
ball. No.
And it dropped in here.
No.
I saw it. I caught it on tape.
No.
No, it's not bullshit. It's legit. It's straight up legit.
So I win.
If it's on tape, it's legit. Everybody.
Who won?
Abby.
No, this is that side and this is my side. She has to score on my side.
Nuh-uh.
Bullshit, that's not how it fucking works.
It
Hell no.
10 minutes later.
Oh my god. It is fucking rambunctious up in this son of a bitch. Well, almost time to wrap this puppy up, and I had to sneak in Miranda in here before I had to go. It's because my mom texted me, like, when are you coming home? And I said, I have no idea when do you want me back, and she hasn't responded. So I was wanted to, you know, sneak in there and the daily Miranda, you know, appearance and the, what is, how the hell do I word this? The end, the scheduled Miranda YouTube appearance, the scheduled appearance, because of the fact that, didn't we meet it in April 2021? Yes, we did.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
Yes, we did. And
Mark, I don't remember that.
I remember we took a picture.
I can't even remember what I did in chemistry.
We met, the first day we met, we immediately took a picture right away. Mm-hmm. Can I remember, and then after you went inside, You know the guy across the street from the crotch, next to the Crotch of Doom, Gabe? Well, I took a picture with his then girlfriend, Abby McCran. I don't know if you met her or not, but it was, I got two pictures that day. That was when we got Summer before Summer even got here.
Oh.
I remember at that point I was excited to meet you because of the fact that Abby and Steve and them talked so highly about you at the time. And when I saw that was your car that day, I'm like, oh, I'm going to wait right now. I know she's coming out to get something. I'm going to meet her. Then, boom, there you were. And then, you know, they say the rest is history. 16 minutes later. And that does it for our 2023 edition of the Winter Dinner with the Fireball Man, who actually does have a YouTube where I could have been tagging his ass the whole goddamn time. So, therefore, subscribe to Steven Sorg, the Fireball Man. Link is in the description. So, now keep in mind, the next lineup of videos, tomorrow, since we don't have anything, we're going to be catching up on, what is it? On the Casey Albin installment of Really Loud House and the Johnny Benson installment of Welcome to Flash. That's going to be tomorrow. But if we somehow run out of time, we can only do one or you can only do one or the other. Depends on how late we wake up tomorrow, how late we go to bed tonight. And so, therefore, the Poker Game Night Season 2 premieres a week from... not next Saturday, but the Saturday after that. And then the Queen of Masi Masa's Greg Biffle Sweet 16 is actually going to be on the 18th. And then... the Spurs-Cavs game to continue to keep the streak alive and the tradition going will be February 13th. And then Chase English's home opener is the 18th. The ViaQuest Basketball Rager will be the 20th. I got to figure out when my cousin Jamila's game is. I got to figure that out when that is. But that's going to be a TV broadcast-style YouTube video as well. The next haircut video is going to be February 11th, so... There's a lot of content I have in store for all you guys as we open the garage and get ready to wrap this all up. So have a good night tonight and a better day tomorrow. Life will give you a lot of lows, but when you hit a high, enjoy it. It ain't for the weak. Goddamn, taste yourself, bring your ass, be you. You have to try harder to do less. You can't deport a dream. Sometimes the worst things in life lead to the best things. Always bet on the side of love. You got to check yourself before you wreck yourself. Sometimes you just got to be present. You never fail until you stop trying. It never pays to worry too much about things. It's never too late to turn the day around. Another day on time, another day to shine. Sometimes you just got to flock yourself, trust your instinct, not back down. Stand up for yourself, not back down to anyone. One for all, all for one, one for all. She love that difference. So take care, everyone. Good night. And I will see you all for the next two videos tomorrow. And the Goldbergs comes back with the Brett Bogan installment this coming Wednesday. So this past week, we didn't miss anything. And now that we're officially running 2023, it's back to our regular scheduled daily lives like we never left right before Christmas break and the big, great blizzard winter of 2020 of big winter wonderland season 2 blizzard 2022 2023 whatever the fuck that was called. Anyway, I need to get the fuck inside and wind down, so see you later, everyone.